गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट ए सब्जेक्ट इंजीनियरिंग मैथमेटिक्स 1 इन विच वी आर लर्निंग अबाउट ए यूनिट 2 पार्शियल डिफरेंशिएशन. इन पार्शियल डिफरेंशिएशन वी आर लर्निंग अबाउट ए पार्शियल डेरिवेटिव. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी लर्न अबाउट ए डेफिनेशन ऑफ ए पार्शियल डेरिवेटिव. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट जेड इक्वल टू एफ ऑफ एक्स कॉमा वाई बी ए फंक्शन ऑफ टू इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल एक्स एंड वाई. If we keep y as a constant and x varies, then z becomes a function of x only. The derivative of z with respect to x keeping y as a constant is called partial derivative of z with respect to x, and it is denoted by del z by del x, or you can it is denoted by del f by del x, also it is denoted by fx x comma y, etc. Now definition of derivative of z with respect to x, that means partial derivative. In simple derivative you denote d, but it is denoted by del, del z by del x. There is a symbol of del, that means it is a partial derivative. It is equal to limit as h tending to 0 f of x plus h comma y minus f of x comma y divided by h. Now if you have to find the partial derivative by using definition, then you have to use this definition, but you have to not mention ki you have to find the partial derivative by using definition. Then you can find the derivative by using this first definition. That means you have to keeping x, if you have to find del z by del x, then you have to keeping y as a constant, and simply you have to find the derivative with respect to del z by with respect to x, del z by del x. If you have to find the derivative with respect to y, then you have to keep x as a constant, and you have to find del z by del y. Now here we have one example. If f of x comma y is equal to x square plus xy divided by x plus y when x comma y is not equal to 0 0, and its value is 0 when x take value 0, y take value 0, then find the fx at 0 0 is equal to 1. We have to given that fx at 0 0 equal to 1, but we have to prove that it is equal to 1. Now we solve this example by using the definition of partial differentiation. Then solution is here, f of x comma y is our function is equal to x square plus xy upon x plus y. Now first of all we simplify this function, therefore we take x out of bracket, that means x common, into the bracket remaining x plus y, divide by x plus y, therefore x plus y cancel out, and you got only x, it is equal to x. Therefore now our function f of x comma y is only x. Therefore by using the definition we have to find the fx at point 0 0, but value of fx at x comma y is a limit h tending to 0 f of x plus h comma y minus f of x comma y divided by h. We have to put the value of x and y 0 0 here. Therefore our limit become, it is equal to limit h tending to 0 f of 0 plus h comma 0 minus f at 0 0 divided by h. It is equal to limit h tending to 0. Now if we put here f of h comma 0, that means in our function x you have to put value of x is h and y is 0. Therefore our function become 0 plus h minus 0 up divide by h. If we put here 0 0, then our function value is become 0. Therefore our total value become h upon h, but h cancel out, it is become limit h tending to 0 h by h is a 1, and limit of a constant function is a constant. Therefore we get it is equal to 1. Now therefore we have to prove that fx at 0 comma 0 is equal to 1. It is proved, therefore its value is equal to 1. Now partial derivative, if we have to find the partial derivative of higher order derivative, then its definition is like that. If we have to find fx with respect to x, that means first derivative is fx, and we have to find second derivative, then it is denoted by f double x. It is defined as del by del x of del f by del x, it is equal to del square f by del x square. That means you already find del f by del x, further its differentiate with respect to x, and you get value of f double x is del square f by del x square. Similarly, if we have to find the value of fxy, that means you have to fx out of bracket y, it is equal to fxy, that means del by del y into the bracket del f by del x. That means you have a value of fx, it's differentiate with respect to y, then you get del square f by del y into del x. Now, if you have to find the value of fyx, that means fyx is equal to del by del x of del f by del y. That means you have to find the first of all value of del f by del y, then second time differentiate it with respect to x, and you got the value of del square f del x del y is a value of fyx. Now, if we have to find the value of fyy, it is equal to fyy. That means you have to find first del f by del y, then differentiate it second time with respect to y. Then we you got the value of del square f by del y square. It is a value of fyy. Therefore, there is a four second order derivative. Four second order derivative 1, 2, 3, 4. First is f double x, second is fxy, third is fyx, and fourth is fyy. If in example you have to mention that find all higher order second order derivative, then you have to find first fx, then fy, then find these four derivative f double dash x, fxy, then fyx, and fyy. Now here there is an example, find all the second order derivatives of f of x comma y is equal to cos 2x minus x square raised to 5y plus 3y square. Here you have to given a function fxy is equal to this cos 2x minus x square raised to 5y plus 3y square. First of all, we have to find all second order derivative. Therefore, we need value of fx and fy. Therefore, first of all, we find the value of fx, then we find the value of fy. Value of fx, that means we differentiate f with respect to x. Now our f of x comma y is a cos 2x minus x square raised to 5y plus 3y square. If we differentiate it with respect to x, but it is a partial derivative, therefore if we differentiate with respect to x, then our y become constant, therefore derivative of y become 0. Now see here is a cos 2x. Now derivative of cos 2x with respect to x is a minus 2 sin 2x minus here x square into e raised to 5y, but e raised to 5y is a function of y, therefore it is remain constant and derivative of x square become minus 2x. Third step, it is a plus 3y square, but it is a function of y, therefore it is become 0. Therefore our fx at x comma y is equal to minus 2 sin 2x minus 2x e raised to 5y. Now we have to find the value of fy at x comma y. That means we have to find first derivative with respect to y of a function f. Therefore we have to remain x as a constant. It is equal to here cos 2x is a function of x, therefore it is become 0. Now here you can see that minus x square into e raised to 5y is a function of x and y both, but we differentiate with respect to y, therefore our x square is a constant. Therefore derivative of e raised to 5y is 5 into e raised to 5y, and it multiply by x square. Therefore it is equal to minus 5x square into e raised to 5y, and derivative of 3y square is a 6y. Therefore fy at point x comma y is equal to minus 5x square e raised to 5y plus 6y. Now we have to find the second derivative of f. That means f double x is equal to del by del x of fx. Now we already find the value of fx, so find the value of f double dash x, we differentiate fx with respect to x. Therefore del by del x of minus 2 sin 2x minus 2x e raised to 5y. If we differentiate with respect to x this function, then we get its value is a minus 4 cos 2x minus derivative of e raised to 5y is as it is constant, and derivative of 2x become 2. Therefore value of f double x is equal to minus 4 cos 2x minus 2 e raised to 5y. Now we have to find the value of fxy. That means we have to differentiate fy with respect to x. It is equal to del by del x, and value of fy we already find. It is equal to minus 5x square e raised to 5y plus 6y. Therefore, it is equal to del by del x into the bracket minus 5x square e raised to 5y plus 6y. We differentiate it with respect to x, then it is equal to minus 10x e raised to 5y. Here 6y is a function of y only, therefore it is become 0. Therefore, value of fxy is equal to minus 10x e raised to 5y. Now, we have to find the value of fyx. That means we differentiate fx with respect to y. It is equal to del by del y of fx. It is equal to del by del y of value of fx is minus 2 sin 2x minus 2x e raised to 5y. We differentiate it with respect to y, then we get the value of, here minus 2 sin 2x is a function of x only, therefore it is become 0, and derivative of this function is become minus 10x e raised to 5y. Now we have to find value of fyy. That means we differentiate fy with respect to y. That means del by del y of fy. Now a value of fy is here minus 5x square e raised to 5y plus 6y. Therefore it is equal to del by del y of minus 5x square e raised to 5y plus 6y. It is become, if we differentiate with respect to y first term, then it is become minus 25x square e raised to 5y. Because with respect to y we differentiate, then x square is constant. And we differentiate 6y with respect to y, then it is equal to 6. Therefore, value of fyy is equal to minus 25x square e raised to 5y plus 6. Therefore, we find all the fourth derivative fxs, xy, fyx and fyy. Therefore, all second order derivative is find out. Now, in Euler's theorem, we use homogeneous function. First of all, we discuss what is a homogeneous function. Homogeneous function is defined as a function f of x comma y is said to be homogeneous function of degree n if f of tx comma ty is equal to t raised to n into f of x comma y. Euler's theorem on homogeneous function is given by, if z is a homogeneous function of x and y of order n, then value of x del z by del x plus y into del z by del y is equal to nz. Here n is a degree of homogeneous function. You can see here in homogeneous function f of tx comma ty is equal to t raised to n f of x comma y. Here value of n is value of here nz. Therefore, if we put value of n, then RHS and LHS become equal. Therefore, if in example you have to find value of this, then you have to only find it is homogeneous function, multiply its by a value of n, that means multiply by its degree. Then you get easily value of x del z by del x plus y into del z by del y. Now, we discuss the example basis on Euler's theorem. In example, you have to verify Euler's theorem for the function u is equal to sin inverse x by y plus tan inverse y by x. Solution is f of tx comma ty. First of all, you have to check our function u is a homogeneous or not. F of tx comma ty is equal to sin inverse tx upon ty plus tan inverse ty upon tx. Here you can see that tt cancel out and you get only function sin inverse x by y plus tan inverse y by x. That means we take t to the power 0. Therefore our function is become f of tx comma ty t to the power 0 f of x comma y. It is a homogeneous function of degree 0. So by Euler's theorem you can say that x del u by del x plus y into del u by del y is equal to 0 into z equal to 0. It is our second equation. Now, first of all, you have to verify Euler's theorem. That means you have to prove LHS is equal to RHS. To verify LHS and RHS, you have to find value of del u by del x, then you have to find value of del u by del y, then multiply value of del u by del x by x, multiply y value of del u by del y by y, then you take addition, then you have to find value of x del u by del x plus y del u by del y. Check it is equal to 0 or not. First of all, we find value of del u by del x is equal to del by del x of sin inverse x by y plus tan inverse y by x. Now, derivative of sin inverse x by y with respect to x is become 1 upon under root 1 minus x by y whole square into the bracket derivative of x by y is equal to 1 by y plus derivative of tan inverse y by x with respect to x is equal to 1 upon 1 plus y by x whole square into the bracket derivative of y by x whole square with respect to x is a minus y by x square. It is equal to 1 upon square root of y square minus x square, and square root of y square become y, here y cancel out, therefore it is remaining only 1 upon under root y square minus x square minus, here y cancel out and you get minus y upon x square plus y square. It is equal to 1 upon under root y square minus x square minus y upon x square plus y square. Now, here there is a value of del u by del x, but we need value of x del u by del x. It is equal to x upon under root y square minus x square minus xy upon x square plus y square. It is our third equation. Now, we have to find the value of del u by del y. Del u by del y, that means differentiate function u with respect to y. It is equal to 1 upon under root 1 minus x by y whole square into the derivative of x by y whole square with respect to y, it is become minus x by y square plus derivative of tan inverse y by x with respect to y, it is equal to 1 upon 1 plus y by x whole square into the derivative of y by x whole square with respect to y, it is equal to 1 upon x. It is equal to, if we take LCM here, then we get minus x upon y upon under root y square minus x square, because here square root of y square become y and here y cancel out, only minus x remaining, here y is remaining. Now, here we take LCM, then it is become 1 upon x square plus y square and here 1 upon x, therefore it is become plus x upon x square plus y square. Therefore, value of y into del u by del y is equal to minus x upon under root y square minus x square, y cancel out, plus x into y upon x square plus y square. Now, you have this equation 3, here this is equation 4. Adding equation 3 and 4, you get our LHS is like that, x del u by del x plus y del u by del y, it is equal to x upon under root y square minus x square minus xy by x square plus y square minus x upon under root y square minus x square plus xy upon x square plus y square. Now this is a plus, this is a minus, therefore both are cancel out, the here minus and here plus, both term are same here, these terms second and fourth also cancel out, therefore you got its value is equal to 0. It is equal to our RHS. You can see here our equation 2 is equal to 0, therefore our LHS is equal to RHS, therefore x del u by del x plus y del u by del y is equal to 0. Hence, Euler's theorem is verified. Thank you.